all remember the books that we first ever read and the books that got us into reading. So today I'm going to be discussing about the books that got me into reading, and that are of course Indian children books. Namaste guys, and welcome to my channel. As a child and as every other child, I was always fascinated by those fairy tale books that would make me dream that anything could be possible. I grew up reading most of the Indian literature children books. I didn't even know about the English books. I read a few of English books that were just a general ones. Most of the books were in Hindi only. So let's get started. The first book is Panchatantra. I really, really love this book. I still reread these books whenever I get time. This book is basically the collections of short story and is actually an ancient Indian literature treasure. This book contains magical tales and animal fable tales. It was originally said that it was written by Vishnu Sharman Ji, who used to illustrate animal fables to two dull-witted sons of a king. Now there's something written here on this book, that is, "Khel khel mein jeene ki kala sikhane wali mazedar kahaniyan." This means that by fun reading stories, you can learn so many different things, aspects of the life. So basically, this is all about this. Most of the Indian literature books are short story books, and these books actually taught us so many things. Every short story have a lesson. Now the next book is Jatak Katha. Again, this is a collection of short story, and also again this is an Indian literature, treasured literature. So here again it is written that Satya Daya Evam Karuna Ka Sandesh Deti Mahatma Buddha Ki Purna Janam Ki Katha. So this voluminous body is basically about Gautam Buddha, concerning about his previous births as a human as well as an animal. Again, this book taught us so many things, and of course these books have illustrations too, like this one in animal fables and some of the human ones. Now the another book is Tenali Rama. I think you all might know about him. So a little about Tenali Rama. Tenali Rama, also known as Ramakrishna, was a scholar, a poet, a thinker and a special advisor in the court of King Sri Krishnadevaraya. He did not receive any formal education in his childhood, but he became a great scholar because of his thirst to know about the things. He is mainly known for his wit and humor. As per a well-known story, Vishnu Vaishnav scholars rejected him to become a disciple because he was originally a Shiva. So while roaming one day, he met a sage who advised him to worship goddess Kali. He worshipped goddess Kali and appeased her with his devotion, and in return she granted him the wisdom and in another bowl money, wealth. She made him choose between the two, but so he tricked her and got the two bowls and just ate it all the content, and thus he became a wealthy as well as a wise man. So again, this is a collection of short stories. Again, this book have some awesome illustrations about him. Now the next one is Mulla Nasruddin. Again, this is by a famous personality. He was a populist scholar and a poet who wrote many funny fancy stories. Actually, he appears in many of his own stories, sometimes as a wise man, sometimes as witty, and sometimes as a fool or butt of a joke. Usually he has a subtle humor. Again, this book is a collection of short stories with some funny stories, with again who taught us many things of life. Now these are some other books of India that are, again, some are in Indian languages, Hindi, that is Arabian Nights. I think we all are might familiar with this. Vikram and Betal, and Raja Harishchandra Rai, and of course Akbar Birbal ke Latife. This is like Jatak Kathais, Bharat ki Lok Kathai, and of course this is English book, that is the Ramayana. And now I have three English books and fairy tales. this contains the same old Disney fairy tales, but yeah, I was a child, so I was fascinated by them. So yeah, this was all my children reading books. There are some more, but they are all the same things. So yeah, I used to read most of the Indian literature books, and now that I asked kids or my relatives or anyone that what are you reading, and they used to say that they were reading Jerry Moe, Nancy Drew. Of course I know Nancy Drew, but I don't even know who was Jerry Moe until now. So I was kind of disappointed that they don't even know about these books. When I ask about them if they read Panchatantra or any other Indian literature books, they don't even know about the names, and that's a rich heritage that should be treasured. I think the most important part in this all reading is from schools. I think we are so much depending upon English culture that we are forgetting about our own culture. English literatures are also so much important, and they of course taught us so many things. Of course those English books are some great books and they should be treasured too, as I myself read most of the fiction English books nowadays. But yeah, as a child I would really like them to read some Panchatantras and Chatakathas. I don't even know if I'm being biased or not. I'm actually being biased with Indian literature. But yeah, those are my thoughts, as whenever I see a kid not reading them, they don't even know them. It made me cry that why don't even they know them, and they don't even talk about them. So yeah, this was me crying over something that is not in my control, but I hope they actually know at least Panchatantra and Jatakathas. That if you like my video or if you have read any of these books, do let me in the comment section. Or if you think that if you are somewhat agree with my thoughts about English literature and how schools plays an important role in that, do comment that in the comment section too. So goodbye to the next video.